What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about creating an automatic deployment rule for Windows Update within SCCM, or short is ADR, because I'm going to use ADR a lot. It's the abbreviation of it. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is open up our SCCM application within your server or within your workstation, wherever you have this particular program into. Just launch it to log into your SCCM server. So the first thing that we need to do is within here, we need to go into software. Within software, we're going to go to overview. We're going to expand the software updates. We're going to go inside automatic deployment rules. Now from here, we're going to right click on that particular node and we're going to select on create automatic deployment rules, or ADR for short. And you're going to get the ADR wizard. We're going to provide a name. I provided the following, right? You are able to click on the drop-down menu for templates and pick a template. Microsoft was nice enough to give us templates. So because I'm pushing out Windows updates, I'm going to do Patch Tuesday. Makes sense. And we're going to click on Browse and then select your collection. For this example, I'm going to do all workstations and then click OK. Make sure that you click on create a new software update group. I like to do that because it gives you a nice little timestamp on the name of the software group. So that's awesome. So we're going to click next here, and I'm definitely going to leave the deployment settings as the default, and we're going to click on next. Now for the criteria, I selected the following criteria for this ADR rule. I pick date released or revised, language, product, and update classification. Now, all the settings for these particular four criterias, I picked the following. I did last 1 month, language was English, product was Windows 11, and update classifications, I did critical updates or security updates. Now, you are able to pick more classifications within your infrastructure. I think they have like features, drivers within the list, but again, it's up to you. For this video, I'm just focusing on critical and security updates. You are able to click on preview and it gives you a nice little behind the scenes if updates are being cached with this particular criteria. Go for it. If not, click on next. Now for the scheduling, this is up to you. You are able to run the rule on a schedule. For this video, I selected run the rule after any software update point synchronization. So I'm going to piggyback on that schedule and then we are going to click next here. Now for the deployment schedule, the only thing that I made modifications here is for software available time, I selected as soon as possible and then I clicked on next there. Now for the user experience, the notifications, I selected hide software center and all notifications from users. For the deadline behavior, I selected the software update installation, as well as a system restart. And at the very bottom, I also enable commit changes at deadline or during a maintenance window, which is going to require a restart. So click next here. For alerts, I left everything as the default. For deployment package, I actually selected create a new deployment package. I provided the package a name and I gave it a path. This is the path that I provided. Now click next here. And I clicked on add, I selected DP, I selected my DP, I clicked OK, click next here. Now for the download location, I left it as the default, which is download software updates from the internet, then click next here. For the language, just click next. For the download settings, I make sure that I have both options enabled here to download updates from the DP and install it, and then click next here. You get a nice little summary, next, green check mark, and then you're able to close it. And then that's it. That is basically how you create a ADR to push out Windows 11 updates to your Windows machines within your infrastructure. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.